This is Tiax. Not too much is known about him.
I know.
He was found raving on the side of some road.
Tiax. We could have picked him up as a companion in the first Baldur's Gate. He's a late one, though. I think we didn't see him until the whole thing was going on with the Flaming Fist and Angelo and all that stuff. Scar was killed. But yeah, that's around the time we found Tiax.
Tiax rules all. You are but grease for the wheels of his rule. Silence the squeaking of those that protest. He rules all.
He's a rogue, I think? Not sure.
Obviously a danger, as you can see.
Why? Because he just says he knows all? Well, we gotta talk to him. I'll talk to him.
Fine.
Tiax shouldn't be an issue. He might be evil, I'm not sure.
He rules all, he does. You are but the left bunion of his wondrous idol. You be grateful for the chance.
Is he supposed to be dead? Yeah, I never had him as a party member. I haven't seen you in ages. I mean, we spoke to him for like a minute or two, so this doesn't fit, and this doesn't fit. Tiax, aren't you supposed to be dead? Who said he was dead? Did someone say he was dead? I don't remember. Yeah, aren't you supposed to be dead? Shrug.
Tiax rules all from this throne room. You are all servants of his majesty, even as you feign ignorance.
I don't know. See, I don't know if he was always like this, or this is the new Tiax. I will treasure this moment, gnome. You're exactly where you belong, says Dorne.
The heavens move because he waves his hand. The waters stir as he twiddles his toes. The wind blows as he passes, and on a whim, he can break them all.
If you're so powerful, why don't you instead speak in the first person and leave this place? We're waiting.
Tiax takes no notice. Go and spread word of his mighty stature. Tiax rules all. Just ask him, and you shall see.
Ask who? Tiax?
Murder, death, kill! Murder, death, kill!
Okay. MDK, right? That's their other game? So, yeah. That's another game by Bioware called MDK. And then they'll leave a sequel that was not by them. Anything else to say?
You have disturbed Tiax the Grand again! Such insolence! Tiax will place a mark of shame upon your forehead. All will know your treachery!
Alright, mark of shame. Is he attacking now? Get me out. It would appear that the great and mighty Tiax has shrunk his undergarments 3 sizes this day. Excuse the mighty Tiax while he catches his breath. He will rule later. We'll be back to kick it later. When Tiax rules, britches will not ride up so wedge-like. Okay. Well, I would rescue him from this place, but he's kind of insane. I don't know if it was always like that.
See, battle bo, run bo, run.
Next room.
An aged elven mage is this cell's occupant. Very powerful, though he is incapable of trusting a soul. Dradil is his name.
That sounds familiar.
Bad dog, bad dog.
werewolves all. Back! Back with you!
Yes, says Mintz, such fire and conviction. A pity there are no actual enemies to warrant the screaming, but good show anyway. Boo applauds.
Obviously, he has had some sort of traumatic experience in the past. He cannot be allowed to roam with the power he possesses.
Tradeal. Of Tethir? Isn't the Tradeal of Tethir? I don't know if I'm thinking of the right person.
Make way, villainy! Hero coming through!
Well, you have a big room. Oh, thank you very much. I'm thinking Dreadeal of Tethir, I don't know why.
Bat kicking for goodness!
I like to get his yelling out of the way so we can just hear what this guy says.
You, do I know you? No, I don't know anyone. Back! Bad dog! Play dead!
No more tests! No more questions! No more! Back! Bad dog!
You, the rank smell of Gulladon the unmanned! Bastard!
Huh! Really? Who's that?
One has lots of time for reflection while waiting for the endless waves of bad doggy werewolf monsters that chew your toes while you sleep!
Personally, I spend the time reconstituting culinary delights from my childhood. Would you like a recipe?
Sure. Something from my mother's mother. We gained Dreadeal's recipe page. Dreadeal's recipe. Omnian Dragoon Soup. 4 cups of beef broth, 8 cups of water, 2 leeks sliced thin, 2 carrots sliced. I guess not thin. 1 celery stalk thinly sliced, 1 small cabbage shredded, 1 large onion sliced, 1 garlic clove minced. Minced, not Minsk. 2 lemons, 4 eggs, salt and pepper to taste. 1. Pour the broth and water into a large pot. Add all the vegetables and bring to a gentle boil. Let the fire burn to a low, medium heat and simmer the soup for 1.5 hours, covered. Add more water if needed. Skim all of the white part that rises in the soup and discard. Squeeze the juice from the 2 lemons and add it to the soup. Beat the eggs carefully and mix them with the soup. Add the seasonings and stir quickly for 2 to 3 minutes. Serve immediately. Immediamente. Well, the eggs will fill you up, that's for sure. Beef broth, leeks, carrots, celery, cabbage, onion, yeah. It seems like a regular recipe. I don't know what I was expecting, but that seems like a regular recipe. Anything else to say? Or a handover?
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
Escape! Escape I will! No kennel will hold what is not doggy. Oh, he's leaving.
Bad dog! Away with you!
He come back. Freedom! Bloody hell! One more time.
What now? Move along! I've rather strained my voice.
Huh.
What now? Move along! I've rather strained my voice.
Alright.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
But this door.
Nothing dangerous, I would hope.
This magical lock will only open for a specific key. No amount of tinkering will help.
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
Imwin?
I can dance on the head of a fin as well.
The one you seek. She is quite well, considering the circumstances.
I think that's a rogue stone.
So empty. Empty.
both. What have you done to her? She looks a mere shadow of herself.
She does not seem willing to respond right now. Her consciousness comes and goes. It is fortunate you arrived when you did.
You monstrous! I'll not leave until you tell me what you have done to her.
Oh, you misunderstand. It is fortunate for me that you arrived when you did. I'm quite through with her for the moment. It is you that I am after.
You seriously saying that the three of us that were there in that dungeon, me, Minsk, and Yoshimo, we don't recognize his voice? Out of anyone, I should be recognizing his voice. But no, a very distinctive voice, just had no idea the coordinator is actually John Aronicus. How sad.
I knew you would seek her, and so the path was difficult but not impossible. All designed to test your potential.
A foolish plan. I am quite capable of countering any cowled wizard ambush. The cowled wizards no longer run the asylum. With Bodhi's aid, I was able to take control quite quickly. She is a fine sibling, if a touch predatory. I trust you remember my name now? Know it all along. That's his actual sister. So, he has a vampire sister. Hello, life knob goblin. Yeah, all of the above, really. That you do. That I do. You are Renicus, and I owe you a great deal of pain. A great debt of pain. Your intent on revenge or justice or whatever, I care not. You can do nothing I do not wish. Yoshimo, I trust everything is as I instructed? What? Everything is instructed. What are you talking about, Arrhenicus? You have no allies in my group. You're mistaken, of course. I have had my interests taken care of from the beginning. Oh, really, could it be? I mean, the way we just came across him in the dungeon. Now I'm thinking about suspiciously not a captive. And Yoshimo has been saying a couple strange things lately. I have had my interests taken care of from the beginning. Yoshimo says, It is a discovery that gives me shame, Sapphire. All is not what I have made it out to be. You have done as you must, Yoshimo. I have seen to it. Now, is everything as I asked? Yes, Master Arrhenicus, just as you wanted it. God, what? What if we had come here without him? Would he just be here? Because we're apparently about to lose him as a party member. I mean, unless he's gonna be a double agent at the last second. So you betray me to the monster? I had thought I earned your trust. What you earn is of no consequence. I don't know why it still says coordinator. Put Arrhenicus there. I took his trust in the beginning. That is all there is to be said. I apologize, Sapphire. There are circumstances that you are not aware of. Viconia says, I know well the proper punishment for those called traitor to their kind. You will have as much mercy as I have been shown, Yoshimo. Olot plindos, walking corpse. Yoshimo, how could you? How could you? Eri says. A slap in the face of our trust, says Minsk. A sword to the heart of our confidence. A boot to the prunes of our friendship. A boot to the... Perhaps I go too far, but Boo was absolutely incensed. I cannot give a reason that will satisfy. Your wrath will come regardless. Well, I could outright threaten him. I'll say discuss it later. Later? When later? Or... hold on a second. I will survive this, despite what you think you had to do. You may be disappointed, but I am well pleased. My servants have proven to be artists with herbs as well as with deception. Your meals aboard ship were prepared exactly to my specifications. My meals aboard ship. What, he drug us too? I mean, we did sleep twice. A very, very slow-acting drug. Bravado, really. I am well prepared for an ambush. Your talk does not worry me. That talk kind of worries me. You will find you are powerless. I have taken precautions that you will not be damaged. Rage would be wasted. There is no battle. No heroics. Only sleep. But I had the Rogue Stone. Ah.
Well, it would seem that my visitor has awakened. It is as I predicted. It all has been.
And you're ugly.
I fear I have had an advantage over you. I have planned your coming from the start. It could be no other way. Had you known of Yoshimo, things might have been different. But a spell component slipped into a soup will still get anyone in the end.
Yeah, it seems like he was forced into it. Right? Like, I don't know if he was ensorcelled against his will, or simply been made an offer he couldn't refuse. I'm sure you forced him into whatever deal you have with him.
It was his suggestion, really. A fine way to retrieve you unharmed. Of course, your safety is no longer a concern at this point.
Ah, you're so sweet. I did not spend so much time in Sapphire's company just to have her killed. That could have been done a dozen times over. You will not be paid. Oh, I guess, yeah, share of the loot. Is that genuine... Oh, paid by Ironicus. Is that genuine concern, or are you worried that you will not be paid if I am a corpse? Paid by Ironicus, obviously. I'm just trying to get something, elicit some kind of response here. Because I'm angry at him, but I'm not sure if I should be angry at him. I mean, was he prevented all this time from telling us? Yeah, are you worried I'll not be paid if I'm a you will not be paid if I'm a corpse? Don't make this harder than it already is, Sapphire. I can't help you. There are circumstances that you are not aware of. You keep saying that. Can you tell me the circumstances? Then I'll be aware of them. The excuse of a betrayer. Then enlighten me. I know of nothing that would warrant such a betrayal. Death, no matter where I would go or what I would do. That is what awaited me if I failed. Can you understand that? My service was promised long before I was called on to do this. I did not know what would come. I did not know what a filthy creature Ironicus truly was. I did not. My service was promised long before I was called on to do this. So he was working for Ironicus way before we came along? Quiet yourself, Yoshimo, and quit babbling about death. You are quite safe now, and my plans for Sapphire go beyond simple murder. You will see soon enough. Beyond simple murder. So that means murder and then more, right?
But don't worry. You won't have to think about any of this or that. Your life ends today.
My life? Well, he said Yoshimo wasn't going to die today, so I guess he means me. Where is Emoin? What have you done to her? Don't worry. Emma Wynne has already suffered what she must for my cause. She even survived, and this bodes well for you. You are stronger, more focused, and you are aware. Aware of what? Aware of what you are, child of Baal. You are aware, and she is not. That makes you more able to focus. You didn't know? What? Are you suggesting that Imowen is a child of Baal as well? That's just not possible. We may both have the same foster father. Also a child of Baal? Not the same mother, right? That's just not possible. You must have suspected. I don't think I did. Perhaps she felt no symptoms, but the taint was there. She is of similar age and was apparently secluded as a child, just as you were. This Garion of yours should have told you about yourselves early on. You might have learned not to fear what you are. Imowen is indeed a child of Baal. I suspect her innocent charm and humor suppressed the darkness. She showed no symptoms because there was no place for shadow in her spirit. Well, it's not like I showed some symptoms. The only symptom I had was being attacked by people working for, what's his name? The baddie from the first game. Why can't I remember his name? Why can't I remember his name? Well, it's on the tip of my tongue. I know his name. It's just on the tip of my tongue. Saravak, thank you. Saravak. So I don't know what kind of symptoms there might be, other than Saravak wanting to kill that person. I had to show her some very dark shadows indeed. It is unfortunate that it had to be done, but it was necessary to get what I needed. Now I must focus on you. I mean, I guess another side effect, quote-unquote, is, you know, the powers that I got. Like, Lorelock's minor drain, and I have a healing spell. So you cast her aside and try to take me? You are vile indeed. I am done with her. You should be more concerned about yourself. There is a very good chance you're about to die. Do you see the shadow thieves in the other chambers? They are the fruits of Bodhi's guild war, and their deaths shall force the divine soul from you. Their deaths? These are all shadow thieves? Don't be afraid, Sapphire. I suspect this will be mercifully quick. Yoshimo, help me. I curse at you and Bodhi. Yoshimo as well. Yoshimo, it's not too late. Help me. You just fire a bolt into his neck. Well, it looks like he's guarded there. Into his skull, how about? His forehead. Help me! It's too late, Sapphire. He can't help you. I've ensured it. And you will soon be beyond it all anyway. Oh, they're in there. Oh, what a wonderful person he is. Rapture of the Father's Shadow Thief. What's rapture?
Do not fight. To fight is to lose. Come to me. Find me.
This reminds me of the little dream sequences in, what do you call it? The Beamdog expansion. DLC. Siege of Dragonspear. I can't remember titles and names right now. Imoin, where are you?
Within. Find me within. You cannot fight alone. You cannot find me within.
Yeah, Yoshimo's gone off of here. Arrhenicus has started to do whatever he is doing, and I have been transported into some kind of dream. I cannot tell what is real and what is not. All I have heard is Imuin's voice calling to me. She says that I cannot fight alone and I must find her. That's some funky music.
Such menial tasks.
Well, within, meaning we go in there. But let's look around a little.
I don't chop wood, okay? I'm not an axe.
What?
Yeah, hearing Lelarkor talk was funny.
Yes, a simple matter.
Find me within. There's another way in, apparently. Those parts in Siege of Dragonspear, I think, were not as interactive. Well, they're over here. I can't go that way. Oh, I can't move them.
Fine.
Strange, I can't walk to them. So that's how I was able to hear Lelarkor. He technically is here with me. As much as someone can be with you in your dream, I suppose. Or something. You're talking about a sword. That talks. So, talking sword, you really shouldn't question anything at that point. It's coming around the other way. Thought about using haste, but let's save it. I don't know if there's things in there to fight, and I'm gonna be by myself. If I'd have known, I would have gone this way first. Well, yeah, I can't get to them. They're right over there. All right. Lava. There's that other entrance. I'm just exploring right now, seeing what's around here. Who's this? Baal? He's coming. Should I be worried? I got ball on my heels here. Fine, what do you want?
Fall to your knees. You can do no other. I am within you. I am your essence.
What do you want here?
What do I want? Your life, your soul, your body. I am the instinct that will fuel the father. I am the blood.
Oh, now he turns hostile. I can evade you with ease, monster. Yeah, I mean, I realize it's a dream. He's not real. I still don't want to be fighting him. What's... There's a demon here we can talk to. This path is to the core, the depths of your soul. Only through sacrifice can you achieve such insight. Do you give of yourself, that you will know yourself? Do you let go of what you are, that you might see from a distance? Choose what you will sacrifice to know yourself, to walk within. Give of your health, your mind, your wits, or your youth. What? I don't want any of that. I'll give him my health, becoming less hardy. No, not mind the capacity to learn. Sacrificing my agility of movement. Okay, so we can have less hit points, less intelligence, definitely not. I mean, we're a spellcaster. Wisdom or agility. I give nothing. You ask too much of me. Then the door holds fast, for you would do more damage stumbling through than any outside force another could muster. Alright, well, he's coming, so... Fine. I give of my wits and the wisdom I have learned. Not a priest class. Then you shall come to know yourself through your mistakes, when you undoubtedly falter with foolishness. A fool can learn much that a scholar does not see. Since when were demons so wise and philosophical? You shall know more of yourself through what you have lost, a gesture of your intent within. Pass as you should, and do not fear what comes. I have encountered a door of some kind, which seems to me to be a chamber to somewhere further within my mind, or my soul. To pass it, I have had to sacrifice something of myself. I wonder if it shall be permanent. Well, my wisdom is 19. All right. Bye, ball.
Such menial tasks.
Lost 1 point of wisdom. I was still 18. Really, what does this affect? Saves? For me? Like... Let's do a flat patch. Yeah, I'm not sure. I don't know if Ball's gonna come through the door here. Has he seen me? He's looking for me over there. These strange noises in this place. Well, there's Imoin. What the hell was that? Wait. I lose my invisibility. Or maybe I already did. Did it wear off? I'm just looking around. I'm sure we can't loot anything in a dream. We can't bring it out, but... See, once I grab Imoin, or talk to her, I have a feeling the dream will be over, so I just want to look around. There's nothing to see here. I think it's awesome that I literally got away from Baal. I just turned invisible and he's like, I knew she worked back here somewhere. He walked back behind the thing and the bookcase. Alright, so that's this whole place.
I can see you there. Wait, and we can win.